No surf browsing. We just work houses. Lowe's weigh as much as Big Pun on his first album. You ever been up in the raid with fast search houses? Bra stuffing bra in a bra before they search couches? The bricks kept in the chirp houses. We had a wave you heard about everywhere like Soup Surf album. We the powder trap house.
15 minutes of fame.
You are now listening to 15 minutes of fame.
Let's go!
All right, man, 15 minutes of fame. Geechee Gotti. Are you still a champ?
Yeah.
Huh?
Come on, man, you know that.
That was a fucking war, bro.
That's a fact.
What was the, was it a war on red? Or?
Yeah. You wore red as a kid. I had issues with whoever wore red Crip shit. You know what I'm saying? And I know niggas seen us get a little, like, you feel me, when he said the word that disrespect, but see, like, I had to holler at cuz, you know, and I'm like, we gonna holler, but at the same time, well, he apologized and said it's bad. That's my nigga. So at the same time, though, I had to tell him, though, see, the people on the outside looking in don't know how much I fuck with you and how much we, you know what I'm saying? So the end of the day, when they hear you, I'm like, come on, cuz, like, you said it once, you know, I'm gonna let it slide with two or three
can
times.
Can you tell the people what exactly happened?
Oh, it was just like, you know, he said something like, nigga, something for this crab. Now, you know, I'm a Crip. Now, that's a disrespectful world in the right. gang culture to a Crip. But we battling. We doing this shit war of words. So we right. let shit right. slide as a war of words. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, I got a relationship with bro outside this shit. We solid. You dig what I'm saying? He know that. And we fuck with each other. You know how we rock with each other. So it ain't even no surprise or nothing. But of course, I'm going to tell a nigga, like, hold on. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm going to tell a nigga off the rip. Whole lounge just out of respect though, because a nigga, you feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Because sometimes it went, you know what I mean? And it can go there. But at the same time, by him being a man, like, nah, my bad. Afterwards, like, I ain't mean, you feel me? And so we rocked out on that. But I could tell him at the end of the day, it's just the perception. Cause the fans don't know, the people don't know, you know what I'm saying? And then at the same time, off top of perception, if it wasn't battle rap, I don't go for that. Mm. You dig what I'm saying? So I don't, you know what I mean?
Don't want motherfuckers to get it confused. Don't get it like confused. It's okay.
I guess okay, cause that verbiage ain't 100, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I wouldn't disrespect a red rag nigga verbally. This nigga right here got red rag on his head. You dig what I'm saying? You dig what I mean? Mm. Like, you feel me? So this real street shit, I'm just saying, like, but in the battle world, you know, we say different shits and but it's still a borderline of respect. So that's why I'm like, hold on, cause we gonna go outside and get down if you keep saying, you feel me? Because that ain't, we ain't finna do that up here all day like that. But he respects it and apologizes. I'm like, man, and we rocked on this and yeah. we gone. That's my God. I didn't want motherfuckers to even think that I was saying that like I don't fuck with bruh, cause I do. You dig what I'm saying? I really fuck with bruh outside this shit. That's my nigga. And I beat him.
And it's battle rap, so it's like everybody wants to say the most disrespectful
that's a fact.
Shit.
No, that's
you
a
know
fact.
What I mean?
No, you know, so and I'm a disrespectful like, nigga. And he even explained that to me. That shit like, but you always do that to me. You be disrespecting. And I get it. I be disrespecting right. niggas. But I it's a thin line when it comes to that. You know what I'm saying? That rag shit that a nigga don't cross unless it's being crossed. You dig what I'm saying? You would never hear me call a Pyru a disrespectful Pyru word. You dig what I'm saying?
In a battle.
You dig what I'm saying? Especially if I fuck with him now. If I wanted to go there, we gonna set it outside. I'm not doing that. Cause right. banging ain't
there
on that
is
all day.
A level
yeah. It's a level
to what
still.
You should
yeah.
say in a battle.
Cause it answers though. And consequences to that, to everything you do in life. You know what I'm saying?
And so, you yeah. did hit him with the line, like, I forget what it was, but it was something about, you know, your boys watching these battles, like,
they be
saying, like, why you ain't
you?
Kill this nigga?
Yeah, on the record. Cause that's the type of shit that happened. Like, man, you can woo, but you know, we getting paid good money to, you know what I'm saying? So it's a respect thing, but it's also, you know what I'm saying, nigga trying to get
line?
The business. Oh, nah, what I say, man, I'm humble because I want to be. I ain't got to, nigga. My niggas be watching his battles, be surprised I ain't shot you niggas, you know what I'm saying? Like, and that's just real talk, though, you feel what I'm saying? Because we humble, because we don't have to be. We could fuck up the whole thing, you do whatever, still, we don't give a fuck. We done been all that shit regular, but
right.
we want to be humble because we getting something out of this shit. Like I say, it's black motherfuckers getting paid, have a world war, so we try to keep it at that. But like, yeah, he did his thing, I did my thing. I feel like I got him. His third, I feel like, was his best round. And my third, of course, ain't always aimed at my opponent. I'm giving you know what I'm saying, that
right.
feel we talking. So I ain't mad at nigga, but them first two, I feel like I got it. His second was fire. First was clear my way. So it's a, you know, I get on this and keep it real with you every time. It's a debatable battle. It's a preference battle because he talked this shit. But niggas
it's
was saying,
a rewatch.
It's a rewatch.
It's
we had a classic.
Yeah.
Smack calling it classic.
Yeah.
That's a rewatch. You dig what I'm saying?
That's and a rewatch. And that's what matters the most.
That's a fact, my nigga.
Yeah.
That's a fact, my nigga. Yeah. On the real. So yeah, we rocking like that, man. That's all we did, man.
Finally,
we got to
see
the champ versus the champ.
Champ.
Versus the champ, man. You feel me? And You know what I'm saying? You feel me? They didn't, we didn't do the judges, so we really, but the belts wasn't on the line as we was talking. But at the same time, though, I wasn't going to take his belt even if they would have did it, because he earned that. You feel me? Like, we had already had that under, like, I don't want your belt. You earned that. When you won it, I got mine. But we still laid them out. You feel me? Made it look good. You feel me? But it was lit, though. Yeah, yeah, man. But
Nitty
and Chilla was a classic.
Crazy.
I think Surf and Reef finna go down right now.
Yes.
15 minutes of fame. You dig what I'm saying? We out here turned up. Niggas know what the fuck going on, man.
Thank you, brother.
For real.
15 minutes of fame.
You are now listening to 15 Minutes of Fame Radio.
Let's go.